She's a perfect 10, but she wears a 12. Baby, keep a little 2 for me. She could be sweet 16, busting out of the seams, and still love in the first degree.
When he's at my game with a big fat aim, you wanna see the smile on my face. And even at my door with a poor phone, there ain't no man can replace. 'Cause we love our love in different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight. 'Cause we love our love in different sizes. I love her body, especially the lies. Time takes its toll, but not on the eyes. Promise me this, take me tonight.
Oh, hello, Dr. Cassidy.
Anna. May I? I hardly recognised you.
I cut my hair. What do you think?
It suits you.
Thanks.
Morning.
Morning, love. This long to make the crossover from nights. Do you think it's your age? It's 8 o'clock in the morning.
Hello.
Young love, she's met someone.
Is it a he or a she?
It is a he. Keep up, Rob.
I don't know. Last week it was a girlfriend. This week's a boyfriend. Who knows, next week she might be a new age celibate.
It's a bit late for that.
I was wondering where you'd got to. Are you well?
Great. Thanks. I need the energy. Marathon cardiovascular workout last night, as the actress said to the bishop.
300 calories an hour on average, so I believe.
Good, because I've been working out a lot recently. In fact, I've been meaning to come and see you, as I want to go on the pill. Commitment or what, but I think I've met, you know, the one.
Congratulations, that's wonderful.
He's wonderful. He's the only man I've ever met that likes voluptuous women for a start. Guess what he does for a living?
Chef?
Close, but no cigar. He ghostwrites cookbooks. You know, for celebrities and stuff. He says I'm his ideal partner. Always up for trying a new recipe and giving an expert opinion.
Sounds great.
You could dash me up a prescription now and save the NHS an appointment.
Sorry, no can do. I have to make routine checks before prescribing the pill, you know, blood pressure, weight. I'm running a drop-in clinic this morning if you want to come by.
Oh, I'll do that.
So she didn't actually admit it?
Not in so many words.
OK, Karen. I would like you to recall exactly what she did say.
You're not at work, Rob.
I'm just trying to examine the possibility that you're wrong.
It's a mother's instinct.
Oh, our little girl is with the man and you don't think to tell me?
Well, I was waiting for the right moment. This obviously wasn't it. Anyway, it's not a man, he's a boy. He's some exchange student, Schmethro Jack.
Exchange student? Where's he from?
Italy.
Oh, great! Oversexed, oversubsidised and over here. What are we going to do?
There's nothing we can do.
Yes, there is. We can talk to her.
I've tried that. It didn't get me very far.
Well, you didn't try hard enough then, did you? Right, OK, it's down to me.
Why are you overreacting? You weren't this bothered when she got up to all sorts with that Elise. And don't get me started on Jack when he was her age.
That is different.
Why?
Because, Karen, it just is.
Oh, it sounds amazing, Gio.
And one bed large enough for two lovers.
I can't. Not tonight.
Imogen, what is there to stop you?
Mountain of coursework and my parents, for starters. Can't it wait till the weekend?
No, I can't wait. My bone, it aches at the feel of your body next to mine. How about we meet for lunch today?
I'm at college.
I can come to your college.
You've only got an hour.
I leave for that hour. Alone, somewhere. Until then, ciao, mi amore.
Okay, that's two stones in a few weeks. You were doing so well on the weight loss program.
My whole life has been one big diet. You name it, I've done it. High protein, low fat, low calorie, low carb. No eating after six, no eating before six, no eating full stop. No more.
Has something happened?
Not something. Someone. Years of being a fat girl trying to squeeze into a thin girl's body, and finally, I can be myself. Well, hallelujah, the milky bars are on me.
That's great, but have you considered the effects on your health?
I've had it with being lectured because I don't conform to conventional stereotype. Health is independent of, and not dependent on, body weight.
Did you read that somewhere?
People of all shapes and sizes can strive for fitness and physical health. I don't drink or smoke. I exercise. I'm a big, healthy woman.
The reason you started the programme was because of sugar traces in your urine. I'd like to test for that, at least. Take it with you. Bring it back later.
Okay. Shouldn't you be at work?
Shouldn't you be at college?
Study period.
Well, time for a coffee and a little chat with your old man, then.
What's this about?
I just hardly get to see you when I'm on nights. Tell you what, I'll make you a nice hot chocolate. I think we've got some marshmallows somewhere.
A hot chocolate? I'm not a little girl anymore.
But you'll always be my little girl.
Going on?
Nothing.
Okay.
It's just that your mum's... She's told me that you've... met someone.
Oh, no, not the sex talk. Come on, it was bad enough coming from mum, but from you, ugh.
So you are having sex with him, then?
That is none of your business.
That's a yes, then.
No! That's a... It's none of your business.
You're my daughter, and while ever you live under this roof, everything you do is my business.
To listen to this, do you mind?
I'm your father. I've got a responsibility to make sure that you are safe.
Year 8, health ed, got it covered. Year 12, media studies, 40 minutes. So?
Fine. Fine, but don't come running back to me when you're pregnant. Do I ever get to meet him?
Cancellation at 4, if that's a help.
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay.
Wait.
Ooh, Alan! How did you know I was here?
Aren't you pleased to see me? Now, are you going to introduce us?
Oh, Dr. Cassidy, this is Alan.
Anna's told me a lot about you.
I hope you're looking after my baby. Now, are you free for lunch? I need an opinion. She has got a great palate. Girlfriend, recipe tester, and food muse all rolled into one. I'm a lucky guy.
Isn't he fab?
Ready to go?
Great. See you later.
See ya. So what is it then?
Oh, we can see.
So, show me what you can do.
do you reckon to the nutmeg bechamel? Overkill?
Mm. Orgasmic. Oh. That was lovely.
Oh, just one more bite.
I'm stuffed.
Never. You're insatiable. It's why I adore you. A woman with an appetite for food is a woman with an appetite for the fun in life.
That was really embarrassing.
I'm sorry. I couldn't wait. You forgive me? Close your eyes.
I caramelized the bananas, and there's a layer of fudge pieces in the base.
I don't know if I should.
It's your favourite. You're the inspiration behind this recipe.
It's one thing liking curvy women, but I'll end up like a blimp at this rate.
The bone is for the dog, the meat is for the man. You are so drop-dead gorgeous, and if you get any bigger, there'll just be even more of you to love. Now go on. I really need to know what you think.
On the weight since we met, and Dr. Cassidy...
I wouldn't worry about what she says. That woman has got single, bitter and jealous written all over her.
Going back in an hour to have my urine tested.
What, for another lecture, you mean? It's typical nanny state interference. Would you like me to come with you? In case she bullies you?
I can't believe I found you.
Well, I'm only glad that you did. Now, are you going to taste this for me or not?
I've got to go.
No, 5 minutes.
I've got lessons.
Tonight.
Look, I'm really behind on my coursework and I've got my mum on my case.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Probably nothing to worry about, but there are still sugar traces in your urine.
She's just eaten.
Well, I'd like to check your blood glucose levels, and I think you should consider resuming the weight loss program.
It's typical medical professional propaganda. With one breath, you say, oh, there's nothing to worry about. And in the next, you insist she lose weight to fit in with your stereotypical preconceptions of what's normal.
I have no preconceptions, stereotypical or otherwise.
Well, I did warn you. What do you expect? There's nothing we can do about it now, so you might as well accept it. Okay, gotta go. Jack's here. Talk to you later.
What's wrong with the old man?
Oh, he's just found out about Imogen and Gio, and he's gone all Victorian father on us. Oh, don't you start. Why can't we be a bit enlightened about this? Do you think you should invite him round for tea? Nice and civilised. Dad can meet him properly, realise he's harmless, and then he'll calm down, I'm sure.
That's... It's not a bad idea.
You think?
Yeah, I'll ask him.
Fat acceptors believe in health at every size, regardless of physical appearance or weight.
That isn't borne out by medical research.
Sorry, medical research carried out by medics. It's a conspiracy theory. For years, the health risks of obesity have been exaggerated or misrepresented and used as a cover for cultural and aesthetic prejudices against fat.
I refute that.
Okay, well, what about mental health? This woman was an emotional wreck when I met her. No self-confidence, low self-esteem.
I'm a changed woman.
You know, not all men like bony chicks, you know. She's gorgeous the way she is.
It's not about you.
I know I'm at fault for daring to defy stereotype because I like voluptuous women. She spent her entire life being forced to conform to fattest stereotypes and putting up with jibes and interference from do-gooders like you. She doesn't need this. Come on, we're leaving, babe.
Stupidity of some patients.
Donut?
No, thank you. An obesity-induced borderline diabetic with a boyfriend who's encouraging her to pile on the pounds. Anyone who'd think he was deliberately trying to fatten her up?
Well, maybe he is. Some men like fattening up their partners. It was a well-known fetish, although not one of mine. I prefer my man flesh lean and muscular.
You're not worried about what Dr. Doom said, are you?
Maybe I should be more health conscious.
You are healthy. You are beautifully healthy. Mm. And if you start eating rabbit food, you will ruin all our fun. Mm. And we love our fun. Go on. You know you want to.
I'm heading off. Got to get to the supermarket. Are you okay to lock up?
Sure.
Thank you. I've got Amy's Italian boyfriend coming around for tea. What's a typical Italian dish?
Osso buco.
Right. It's back while it is then. Night.
Night, Carol.
Good day.
Fine. Thanks. You?
Fine. Thanks. What's for dinner?
No, hello, nothing, just what's for dinner.
Oh, sorry, hello.
Spaghetti bolognese. It is Italian theme night. Gio is coming over with Jackie for dinner.
What?
If he's special enough to... Then he's special enough to introduce to me and your dad properly. Nice and civilised.
Surprise!
Pizza! I hope you're up for round two. Oh! Hello!
Hi.
It's, not a very good time.
Clearly. But I need to speak to you.
Oops. Caught in the act. It's only a bit of fun, you know, role play.
This isn't fun. This is dangerous.
It's none of your business.
Can't you see what he's doing? He's feeding you up. He's supersizing you.
Alan's a fat admirer. That doesn't mean...
Alan's not just a fat admirer, Anna. He's a fat feeder.
What's going on?
Jack tells me your dad's got a vineyard. He must know a lot about wine.
I know a lot about drinking it.
Bet you do.
So, Mr. Hollins, what is your job?
I'm a policeman.
Why, strange, no? The English police, they don't have guns. How do you frighten il criminale without weapons?
We have other ways of scaring people to death.
How long are you going to be in England?
Only one term, but I am thinking about transferring to an English university.
It's a bit sudden.
I'm Italian. Our head speaks, but we follow our heart.
Was that your heart? Or your...
Would you like some more wine, Gio?
Si, grazie.
Rob?
No, thank you.
My heart and my muse. Your daughter really inspires me, Mr. Hollins. I've never felt so impassioned to write. Ever since our first meeting, every day I have spurted.
He wrote you a poem?
A sonnet. To a mid lady.
Well, that's nice. Name is your...
Thanks, Gio.
A poem? I'm very fond of poetry.
Dad.
No, we'd like to hear it, wouldn't we?
I know what you are.
I don't have to listen to this. I think you should go.
Alan likes big women. You make it sound like some sort of perversion.
Fat feeders get sexual kicks from fattening up their partners. As these women get bigger, they get more dependent, relying on men to wash, move, oh, and of course, feed them. Isn't that right, Alan?
Who the hell do you think you are? You know nothing about me.
I suspect you're responsible for these.
You took these? Where the hell did you get them?
From a website. Big is best, where obesity is beauty. Isn't that right?
I've got nothing to hide here. You know I look at websites, it's not porn.
I thought these were private.
Look, I'm sorry. I should have asked, so be angry with me for that, but not for being proud of you.
He's not proud of you, he's proud of your fat. Those are records of your weight as you get larger and larger. He's fattening you up like a goose, and believe me, the effect on your liver is just as detrimental. That'll be your pizza.
Dark slumber of a sweet embrace, two soft pillows in fall and swell, twin mounded hills and mossy dell, hidden treasure, sweet bottom grass, deep sombre yearnings comes to pass.
Well, that was beautiful.
Very nice, Gio.
Awesome.
Thank you.
That's awesome. Cheers.
Goodbye, Doctor.
I think you should go.
He's fattening you up for his own pleasure.
He loves me.
This isn't love, it's abuse. It's about control and dominance.
Are you listening to her? Now I'm an abuser.
Using fattening methods like overstuffing, coaxing a woman to eat when she's full so she eats more each time. Sound familiar?
Propagandist claptrap. I empower you.
She's no more empowered now than she was before. You've exploited her vulnerability, making her a victim.
What, because I tell her over and over how much I love her for who she is, not for what she looks like?
Would you love her if she was thin?
Would you? If my health is at risk, would you help me diet?
I'm physically and sexually attracted to overweight women. So what? Lock me up and throw away the key.
I would. Men like you are a danger to women.
If it wasn't for men like me, women like her wouldn't get a look in. She should be grateful.
Get out, Alan.
So you don't believe a word she's saying, do you?
Get your stuff and get out of my house.
Well, it's very, very nice to meet you, son. So now we have met, don't you be a stranger. You consider us a home from home. Isn't that right, love?
Yeah, drop around any time.
Thank you for your welcome. I am overwhelmed by your hospitality. Will you take a walk with me?
I've got to work.
With your permission, of course.
Be my guest. Go on, kids. Go and have some fun. That's it. Bye.
Well, that went really well, didn't it? I told you he was a nice lad, a bit tense mind.
I'll give it a week.
Before you met me, you were just another unhappy fat chick. You think about that. And if you change your mind, you know where I am.
You did the right thing.
I hope you're not expecting me to thank you.
It might not feel like it, but
I want to be alone.
Bye, Ben.
Seems like a nice boy.
Just don't.
Hey. Don't forget these.
She's dead.
No, she can't be.
Of course I'm crazy, crazy for love.
It's in the cellar.
But it is a beautiful morning, is it not, my love?
Please. I don't know what to do.
Just deal with it.
Emma!